All right, what's up, everybody? Today on Tools and Action, what are we talking about?
The Denver boot.
No, it's close. It's like the Denver boot, but it's not the Denver boot. Basically, we got the PGA trailer, you guys. Like $4,000 trailer. I mean, it's one of my favorite things here at TIA, and I never want it to get stolen. So with trailers, trailers get stolen all the time, especially in the Chicagoland area. They disappear like crazy because all you got to do is spray paint them, zip off the VIN numbers, and go to the state of Illinois, pay them $80, and get a new homemade trailer VIN number.
Yep.
So, but our trailer, if someone actually steals it, oh man, there's markings all over it. I will find it. I will track it down, and I will find it. And chances are, I will be bringing an AR-15 once I find it. But anyways.
If you ever seen that shooting video, don't be scared.
Yeah. That was the old Dan. Okay, look at those keys. They look like guns. Yeah. Okay, a couple cool things, you guys. So I've tried security for the trailer before. I have one of those gorilla locks that go on the thing there. And, you know, you can just whack those things off with a hammer. But actually, mine broke. The key broke off in it. So I was like, this thing's a piece of junk. I need something that's going to be hard for somebody to steal. No matter what, it could get stolen because the trailer's movable. They could back up here with a semi and have like five guys pick it up and throw it on the semi, whatever. You know what I'm saying? So at least a trailer lock is going to slow them down to enough to cause suspicion, neighbors, somebody seeing it, saying, hey, what's going on here? So cable locks around the wheels, you can just cut those off. So Trimax, you guys, we found this company called Trimax, and they make tons of trailer accessories, all kinds of trailer accessories, different kinds of wheel chocks, receivers, balls, all that stuff. And basically this, like Eric said, it's kind of like the Denver boot. It goes around the wheel of the trailer and creates a chock. So if the thief does...
Just like that picture.
Yeah.
If
I mean,
you can see it.
Well, I'm going to overlay. I'll do it today. I'll overlay it. So basically, if a thief is taken off, you know, I mean, he's got to try to cut this thing off. So then someone, I was reading on somewhere, someone came along and said, well, that's pretty stupid because someone could come and take the lugs off and take the wheel off, which is true.
Yeah, never thought about that.
Right? Someone could take the wheels off. But if that happens, then you got a guy driving a trailer down the street with either one wheel or three wheels. You know what I'm
saying?
Yeah,
but if you got a spare or something, throw a spare
on there.
Well, if he
brings, okay, let's just go to, let's visit that. Okay.
That's guys, you know what? If a guy's going to go through that much
right,
stuff to get a trailer.
That's what I'm saying. And by the time the guy is doing that, I mean, it's good for him to swap that wheel to do that. I mean, that's at least 5 minutes.
You've never been downtown then.
Well, no, but I mean, that's going to create ruckus. I'm going to hear it, this and that. Another way to prevent that is put wheel locks on.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? So I'm going to get a set of wheel locks. And I don't know if you guys have seen wheel locks. Basically, there's a special key that goes on an impact to release it. So then he can't get the wheel off. Then if he can't get the wheel off, he can't flatten the tire. But it's like, okay, he could come in and, you know, take the wheel off. Well, yeah, you can get a plasma cutter, too, and cut the thing off.
Oh, good
you
idea.
Know?
Good idea.
UFOs can come and beam the thing up. You know what I'm saying?
I didn't think about that one
either. I mean, there's tons of ways to steal a trailer. This is going to, you know, this is not going to 100% stop them. But it's one of the best options out there.
It's a deterrent, basically.
Yeah, it's a huge deterrent, and it's a great option out there. And it also doubles as a chock, so the trailer's not going to go blowing around in a storm or anything like that. Comes in two sizes, the TL75 and the TL65. Fits all kinds of tires, tire sizes, and it's not going to damage your wheels, guys. This right here is like plasti-dipped. It's rubber-coated. The key right here has a cover, so if you're worried about snow and grime getting in the lock, it's not going to happen. Round key, it's a weird looking key, fits in there, unlocks it. You know, to me personally, I mean, I don't feel so nervous with my trailer with this thing on it now. Because it, like you said, it is a deterrent, you know? Anybody sees someone drives by, I mean, this is a busy street, someone drives by and sees some guy out there with a friggin' lug nut taking off a wheel with this thing on it, it's going to raise suspicion, you know? And not only that, I'm going to see it on the cameras. I'm going to get a beep on my phone and be, like, out there or call somebody. And, you know, by the time he gets it off, you know, what? Why is that funny?
Be out there with your AR-45 asking him what he's doing.
AR-45?
AR-4, what am I saying? AR-45. I'm thinking of the, never mind.
I don't want to know what you're thinking about.
I have
about.
No idea what an AR-45 is.
Chalk it and lock it, you guys. Trimax. What's their website, Eric?
Trimax.com.
No, TrimaxLocks.com.
Oh, I was close.
Yeah, check it out, you guys. Let me know what you think. ATVs, pretty much anything you could steal. And that's the problem with trailers, especially light trailers. People can pick up light trailers, mm-hmm. you know? That's what sucks. So it doesn't matter if you have a hitch lock or a lock like this, you know? Unfortunately, with enough people, they could take it off. But even with, you know, if you have it chained to a post or something, they can cut that. You know what I'm saying?
Cut through a light post.
If they want it bad enough and as long as it's movable, hey, there's people cut through light posts. Check this out. There was a downtown Chicago, they stole a ComEd truck with a winch and went to a building under construction and hooked it up to the copper wire and winched out all the wire to sell it.
Wow.
Yeah, and they found the ComEd truck on scene running. And all the copper wire was gone. And it cost the company like $200,000 who was building it. Yeah, it's one of my clients told me that.
Nice.
Yeah, because he's like, hey, we're putting all new copper in this building. I'm like, oh, I thought you already did that. And he's like, nah. He's like, they stole it.
Wow.
Can you believe that? So thieves will find a way. But luckily, companies like Trimax will give you the best possible option to prevent it from happening. So go ahead, you guys, check it out, TrimaxLocks.com. Don't forget to check out Tools in Action, Ultimate Tool Bag Giveaway. Let us know at the bottom what you guys think of Trimax and the PJ trailer. Tools in Action.
Remember, for more exciting tool action, go to toolsinaction.com.